Dealer Saxon Durrant has come to Bridport in Dorset. He's in search of enlightenment about a dilapidated Buddha.
The main reason I'm here today is to find out a valuation on the Buddha, some provenance as well. Obviously, it's a religious figure, so is it ethically sound to restore this and do any work on it? That's a major concern, I think.
Hello, Saxon.
Hello, Ray. Good to meet you.
Welcome to the showroom.
Wow, I'm definitely in the right place.
Come on through.
Okay.
Antiques dealer Ray Poole has dealt in religious iconography for 20 years. He has the biggest collection of antique Buddhas for sale in the UK.
So there's lots of different Buddhas around here, but none of them look like the one I've got.
Ah, yes. A Hoti. Looks like a rather large Hoti as well.
Right.
This is a Chinese monk.
So not the Buddha?
Not the Buddha. Buddha is normally in meditative pose.
Yeah.
He's got his eyes closed. This chap is definitely laughing.
Oh, he is.
Often referred to as a laughing Buddha.
Worshipped today as the god of contentment, the so-called laughing Buddha was based on a cheerful Chinese monk who lived over 1,000 years ago. The Chinese call him Budai, and the Japanese Hote. He is a protector of children and the weak.
Well, you can see he's holding a sack.
Yeah.
The sack is there to contain your problems. He'll put them in the sack, then he can move to his worry beads, and these will take your problems away.
Well, at the moment, I'm worried about the restoration. Ethically, is it okay to restore these things?
It's not a problem to restore him at all. The fact that you are cleaning it and restoring it, it means you're revering it. It means
that you're
actually respecting the sculpture.
Yeah.
It's just a shame he's got into that state. It needs a lot of work by the look of it.
Yeah, I think it's been outside for years.
A lot of this stuff came out in the sort of 60s and 70s. This is when people sort of did up apartments and things and started using a lot of this stuff, you know.
So you think definitely 20th century?
20th century, yeah.
So once we've done all this work, what do you reckon it'll be worth?
For the interior design market, it's going to be £1,500, £2,000.
Right.
If it comes out really, really nice and you are really impressed with it, you maybe could get a little bit more for it.
So it wasn't a Buddha. Wow. I was very surprised with that, but it shows how little I know and the value of an expert. Hote, folklore figures. The age was a bit of a revelation, really. I thought it was a bit older than that. The main points for the restoration are the beads and the bag as well, as they're so important to Hote. They're a real luck charm, I think. Can feed all that back to Alex and Nick and see how they get on.
A few days later, sculptor Nick begins to rebuild the Laughing Buddha. He has repaired the worst cracks with plaster, and now that's dry, he embarks on the most important phase.
I'm just going to make a complete mess, get it on nice and thick.
Replacing the sculpted layer of concrete.
Going to paint this on around about a millimetre thick. And as you can see, it actually thickens up the moment it goes on. This is, you know, drying quite quickly on here, but I have, you know, by using this water, I can make it quite malleable.
The statue must be wetted constantly, or the soupy mix will dry too fast and crack.
You know, this piece is quite a, almost like it's been formed by painting over, you know, which is quite, it gives it a nice sort of, almost a soft rock look. It's gonna go over the head quite finely, go over the top with a big brush. I don't wanna destroy any of the fine sculpting on here, so all I'll do is I'll get the smaller brush and just rework areas. I'm doing it exactly the same way as they did it.
This stone look is what Saxon is hoping Nick will enhance in the final decoration. Dealer Saxon asked him to replicate the weathered stone look of the old statue. But Nick has done his own detective work.
It's really interesting. I'm looking at the research of classical painting and especially sculptures. They used a lot of gold and blues together because it sort of represented the heavens. Subconsciously, it's supposed to make people really happy. So obviously that's probably why there's blues and yellows and golds in Buddhas. Now I'm able to do these colours, you can actually depict the different areas. When it first came in, it was in such a mess. You couldn't define which was which and what was what and where the robe started. And so it's quite interesting. Do you know what? I don't think this is a pillar that he sat on. I've suddenly realised, now I'm painting the robe out and I can see the separate areas. That's his sack of dreams. It connects up all the way round to him holding it on the hand. No way. You didn't see that until you start putting the paint on. So it's really cool that it's starting to make sense. It's good to experiment, especially with things like this.
3 days later, Saxon's heading to Colwyn Bay to collect his Laughing Buddha.
It's been a fair few weeks since he dropped it with us, and we've got a bit of a surprise for him.
Saxon, hi, Alex.
Good to see you again.
And you?
Hi, bud.
Nick, nice good to meet you.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
A grand unveiling. I know initially we discussed that stone, mossy, sort of weathered look.
Yeah.
But we've gone for a bit of artistic license on this one.
After the research, and I just felt it needed to be, I don't know, let's say a little bit blinged up for you.
Right. Yeah, as a sort of antiques dealer, I'm kind of into kind of muted tones and that sort of thing. And the word bling sort of sets alarm bells ringing.
I'm a bit of faith. Are you ready?
Go on.
One, two, three.
Sorry, I'm processing. I'm processing. There is a lot to take in. Yeah, there's a lot to take in.
I researched, you know, the colours in the Buddhas and what he's supposed to represent. I just thought, do you know what? I think it should be coloured because it separates all these important things like the beads and the sack.
I think the fact that you found that it was originally painted,
yeah,
that makes it right.
3 weeks ago, this huge Laughing Buddha was splitting apart through weather damage. Its woodwork was unstable, and the concrete detailing was flaked and broken. Now it's restored to full glory. Alex has made the woodwork strong and stable, and Nick has re-sculpted the detailing and painted it in colours that reflect Buddhist tradition.
It could go to, like, a yoga retreat or hotel lobby. Yeah, I think on balance, yeah, great job. I really love the Hote statue now, and I think Alex and Nick probably had a little bit too much fun with this one, but what a great result. Pleasure as always.
Thanks.
I think you liked it.
Yeah, well, I'm happy about
it. How can he not like it?
Bloody hell, mate.
How can he not like it?